I'm using this sensor, which is a short-range, up to 900 millimeter sensor, with an analog 0 to 10 volt output and an MPN output with a quick disconnect for the cable. This is a 100 to 900 millimeter sensor, so we can set the detection range anywhere in here. That determines when the discrete output turns on and where the analog output starts and stops. Let's try it. First, place an object at the max distance you want to cover, and then hold the button down for 1 second. The sensor LED turns on. Now move the object to the nearest distance you want to detect. Press the button for 1 second. The LED turns off, blinks 5 times, and then turns back on. That's it. I have one of these cables with the LEDs built in so I can monitor the outputs, and you can see that as I move the object farther away, the LED on the analog pin gets brighter. That corresponds to the analog voltage increasing. But when I exceed the maximum distance I set, the LED on the discrete output pin goes off. Perfect. This sensor ships with the output normally open, so it closes when a target is found. What if you want to invert that? Well, that's easy. Just hold the button down for 8 seconds until the LED starts to blink fast. Release the button, the LED blinks slowly. When the LED stops blinking, the polarity inverts. You can see that here. This LED indicator that's connected to the discrete output is off when a target is in range. Note that this also inverts the analog output. The LED connected to the analog output gets brighter as I move closer to this sensor. That's the opposite of what we had before, right? So now the voltage looks like this on our chart when we invert the output. Suppose you just want to detect all the objects from the minimum possible range to some fixed point. Well, that's easy. Just cover the sensor when you set the min range. It will default to the min. Now that doesn't work for the max range. Don't set the sensor distance past the max rating for the sensor, in this case 900 millimeters. It may give you unpredictable and unrepeatable results, so be careful with that. A few notes. These settings are preserved even if the sensor is powered down. Make sure you mount the sensor with the provided rubber gaskets. They help provide vibration isolation. Also, make sure you leave about 5 millimeters of the housing exposed below the face of the sensor, so don't mount the sensor flush to the panel. Make sure the power supply meets the specs in the datasheet, the cable extensions are kept below 100 meters, and that the cables are shielded and grounded to help prevent electrical noise issues. To clean the sensor, just use a rag that's been dampened with water to wipe it down and then dry it off. Don't use solvents, acids, or even hot water or steam to clean the sensor. Well, that should be enough to get you up and running with these sensors. Check out the how-to videos that show you exactly how to wire them to a PLC and how to program that PLC to use them.